Hello and welcome to yet another Plug and Play review. Yes, I know, another one. Just how many are there? More than you'll ever know. So yes, today we're going to be reviewing SpongeBob SquarePants Plug and Play, where literally you just play with his nose and pop a zit on his forehead. Excellent, right? Excellent. Now, what can I tell you about this one? Year it was released? I don't know. It's that early on, there's no year on it, so this is probably one of Jack Specific's earliest ones, maybe? Oh, no, I lied. Well, it is actually one of their earliest ones, though. 2003. Damn, we've gone backwards. So yeah, this is one of their earliest ones. So you literally just play with this joystick. It's not clicky. Unfortunately, it is quite gummy. This one is a little bit older. There's a few little frays here and there. But, you know, the overall design aesthetic, that is not bad. That's not bad. Look at that. That's SpongeBob. Having him on your wall like that, yeah, pretty cool. Nice little display piece. Plus it's got a bunch of games on it. Don't know how many. I don't know. I've not even booted this thing up yet. What video ports does it have? Well, it's got the age-old, tried and tested composite video and mono audio, which means you require a little adapter. Now, I've upgraded my setup. I am now using this, which is a little bit better, because the one I was using was just wire. So, it eventually died, because wire, what happens when you use a wire a lot? It breaks on the inside. But now this is actual hardware, so now it is not stereo, but hey, it can go in the left and right audio ports, which is now good. So let's get this plugged into the Elgato capture card and find out what's on this. SpongeBob SquarePants. Developed by HotGen. Jack Specific. Plug and Play TV Games. Released in year unknown. They didn't actually write it on this one. Well, it must be an early one. Because, yeah, the sound is working. There's just no music at all. Press fire to continue. How about that? There is actual sound. How about that? So they've just got this really lame sound here. Well, if for those of you who are fans of SpongeBob, here's five fantastic games on your SpongeBob Plug and Play TV games. Let's use the joystick and play SpongeBob's Bubble Pop. Huge mysterious bubbles are surrounding Bikini Bottom and blocking all of the exits to the city. SpongeBob has taken it upon himself to burst every last one of these nasty bubbles and free Bikini Bottom once more. Bounce the ball into the bubbles using SpongeBob. Don't let the ball sink into the sand and get lost. Collect bonus letters to increase your score. Grab items to help you. Awesome. Music! Oh my god, look, music! And it's gone. Don't ask me why there's no music. There just isn't. And there's no menu button as well, there's just the reset button. So, there's no way to go into like the options and be like, this is an acceptable. So yeah. It does bother me quite a bit, because, well, we've got a lot of game here, and not really any music to show for it. What's the point in grabbing it if you can't even pop it back on? There you go. Can I just do that infinitely? Let me just keep catching it. There we go. What's the worst that could happen? Oh my god. This is terrible. Okay, now I have to somehow get the last one. Yay! Damn! Oh. There's like literally nothing that governs the direction of this thing. Success! Success! That animation! Wait, what? Well, SpongeBob has now been suckered into... What the heck? That's horrifying. I'm just laughing at his face. That is the dumbest thing I've seen. I love dumb things. And that is one of the dumbest. Love it. Aw, that made me back to a normal size. I wanted a bigger head again. Oh, you're slower though with the bigger head. That's fair. Oh, and the base... Oh no, the ball landed in the thing. Whatever shall I do? So, that's what the ball did. The ball lets you grab it. Aha! That's fair, I suppose. Doink. Love how he's just like, I'm helping. I'm just standing here and letting a ball slap me on the head. I am helping. I love it. It's hilarious. Wait, so what happens if we hit the barrels without all the bubbles being gone? What's the snail? That just slow the ball down? I don't care about it being slower. Meh. So yeah, this is pretty much Breakout. It's essentially SpongeBob Breakout. And it is fun enough, but And I guess that speeds it back up, I guess. Yay. But anyway, let's go back to main menu and play another game, because this is literally Breakout. So, I think we've got to the bottom of this one. Let's go. Alrighty. Sandy Surf's Adventure. A giant bullworm and its nasty henchmen are terrorizing Bikini Bottom. Against SpongeBob's wishes, Sandy has decided to repel their attack on her own. Can she save Bikini Bottom from this terrible menace? To help Sandy out, collect the orbs of power. These give her the following advantages: speed up, extra life, rapid fire, and three-way. Woo-hey! Watch out for the bullworm's henchmen. Get ready. Fight! It's like a shmup! It reminds me of that level on Super Mario World Land. Whatever. Super Mario World, I think it is. The Game Boy one. I know, I've played so many hours of it. I think it's Land. Yeah, it's literally that. Sorry, I've just got the Mario theme in my head now. Oh, snap! Yeah, it is like a shmup. Nice. I don't even have to move. Unfortunately, there's no rapid fire seat. I got all the stars. I know that sound. They stolen that sound. That sounded like Galaxian there for a second. Oh, my thumb's getting cramp. Ah! He says as his thumb gets cramp. Can we continue, please? Don't you dare start again. Right, let's get the speed up. You're hitting all those stars. Yes. This button's very stiff. My thumb gets tired okay? Old man down and all. The noises are repetitive. I'm finding it very disappointing that there's no music in the background. I really do. Knowing me, I'll have probably put like the Mario theme I was humming in the background. Nah! Okay, that was on me. I wasn't paying attention. I was too busy laughing at my own stupidity. So anyway, yeah, this is pretty much like a shmup with a bunch of little power-ups and stuff, which is pretty neat, don't get me wrong. So let's jump on to another level. Invasion of the Hooks. The Hooks! The Hooks! They dangle down with their pleasing shapes and beguiling colours. What? And just when you think you've found the land of milk and honey, they grab you and haul you up high. What on earth is this? See, you can tell I don't watch much SpongeBob. Bikini Bottom has an influx of dangerous hooks, and it's up to you to keep them at bay. You what, mate? Fire the Krabby Patties at the hooks. Don't let your friends get dragged off screen. Some hooks require more hits than others. One hit for red, two hits for green, three hits for brown, black, brown, and four hits for the blue. Collect kelp bars for extra points. Love how SpongeBob looks like he's helping again. Oh, so we just have to stop three hooks? Yeah, this is easy! Don't you require three? Yes, you do. And don't you require two? Yes, you do. I want you. Yes, points. Not that I care. And aren't you four? Yes. Dan remembers the numbers. Just throw burgers. Throw all the burgers. Make all of them. All of the burgers. It's the only way. Put Patrick down. No, this is Patrick. Sparta Patrick. Oh. Did the bubbles mean I've won? I think the bubbles mean I've won. Bah! SpongeBob is impressed with his ability to stop hooks. So, this is from, 2003, was it? 2003, that's crazy. Oh, it's been stolen. 2003, God, that means this is 15 years old. Oh, need another one, and that one needs two. But yeah, 15 years old, that's crazy. I'm more amused that SpongeBob has been around for so long. I know he'd been around a while, but isn't that taking the cake? You can try. They can take our people, but they'll never take our Krabby Patties. Oh no, we're in trouble. No, you don't. Give him back. There we go. Aha. Victory is mine. Put that down. You don't know where he's been. Put that down. Victory is mine. Once more. Always mine. Victory. Yes. Stage complete. So how many, I don't know how many stages there are, but I'm going to aim for like 1,000 points and then probably go jump onto another one. Well, I already slapped that one a few times. Slap that one once more. Aha! Candy! Yes! I mean, these minigames are fun enough, I suppose. They've definitely got the fun factor to them. It's just missing the background music. I imagine it would get annoying for parents, and I imagine that's why the earlier Jack-specific plug-and-plays didn't actually have much background music. Maybe they wanted the kids to not be as noisy with them, maybe? Because it's all repetitive? I don't know. We could definitely tell the difference between the older ones and the newer ones, because they have the background music, they have fun variety levels. It seems like these guys were just starting out with just making fun minigames. Not much difference in them either, reusing some animations here and there. And we've won this one, let's move on to the next game. Patrick and the Maze. Patrick, the starfish, has managed to get himself and his friends lost in a coral maze. Fortunately, there are many items found that may help Patrick escape the maze. Only with skill will Patrick escape and return home safely. Little do they not know that they can actually swim. So they could just go up. So I can slap things in the face with the thing, but I can't pick up whatever that is. Okay, can I slap you in the face? Ah, sweet. Oh, neat! I can kill people with other people. Okay. Can't eat him. Never mind. Little Patrick is just like, yeah, I'm dead now. This could have ended better for everyone. Oh no. Waterfall. I'll go down the waterfall. Sweet. And we'll go down another waterfall. Oh, there's gold there. My good fellow, I hear from a very reliable source that there be gold in them there hills, boy. Yes. I'm here for the coinage. Oh, he's gone for a wander. I'm gonna eat you. Come here. I'm gonna eat you. Come here. Come here. Rude! Oh, that is so rude, and you know it, game. So rude. Where's the exit? I don't know why there's lines appearing on the screen. I can't help but think that perhaps it's corruption? Perhaps? Of, not the video, but, the plug and play, perhaps? Oh, Krabby Patty. Oh, damn. Oh, rude. The burger means I can run. I'm the Flash. What? Is the snail the exit? Okay, that noise is annoying. Musical clams. The clams are feeling musical tonight. Remember the notes in the tune. Wait. Remember the notes in the tune the clams play, and then play it back correctly. Use up, down, left, and right to move to the correct clam. You what, mate? What? What? Am I missing something here? Yeah, I see those lines in the middle of the screen. That is visible on my end, by the way. It's not a rendering glitch. And apparently I die if I hit electric. No, that does make sense. That's fine. Wait, so I can't go back up there now? According to the game. Oh, did I just retry? Oh, okay. None of this gets... I don't get it. Right, do I press up immediately or what? Okay, game. Worst game ever. Right, oh, right, right. Oh my god, yes! Oh, this is a video game, yes! 10 out of 10. Congratulations, you have beaten the first stage of the challenge! Now, complete the challenge again to unlock the barrier. Again? Wait, what? I am so confused by this. This makes absolutely no sense. Is it the same pattern? No. Alright, so it's right, left. Right, left. Right, left, right. Yes. Right, left, right. Down. Right, left, right. down. Right, left, right, down, down. Right, left, right, down, down. Yes! Yes! Take that! The barriers are now open so you can progress through the maze. Yes! No! No, I don't want to do it again! Quick! God damn. Alright, here we go. The Super Chum Bucket. Plankton has used his remote control robots to capture Sandy Cheeks to bribe SpongeBob into giving him the delicious Krabby Patty recipe. SpongeBob will never give away the recipe and decides to risk life and Sponge to rescue Sandy himself. You... I love how, like, the first thing I did was absolutely epic fail. Is this... Oh, my God. Yeah, This is Donkey Kong. This is literally Donkey Kong, isn't it, game? It is. You can't even deny it, game. It totally is. Quick run. Right, wait for the next batch to come down. Send down the next one. I know there's going to be another one. Don't. Alright, I'm going. I knew it! Did I say there was going to be another batch? I knew it. Plankton, you're so predictable. You don't even have to try to be predictable. You're just predictable. Alright, so we got ourselves some platforming to do. Sweet. Just need to get to the other side. And then this time, I want to sit there and wait. That's right. I'm going to wait. I'm going to stand right here, cute as could be on this ladder, and be like, yeah, I'm safe. That's right. Knew it. Let's go. Let's get him. Yes, your face. Yeah, you better run. Victory is mine. Oh, no. Oh, this is probably like one of the most fun out of all of the minigames. Right, so is he throwing down things still? Or is that just the first level thing? No, I see the things. Oh, no, this time he's just got the power on. Okay. I got this. Alright, so he's turned it off. No! Oh! Alright, we gotta do this. Oh, serious beans. Oh man. Hey, at least. Oh, you've got infinite retries. That's good. That's good. Definitely want to check those out. Alright, let's go. Alright, so I'm not even worried about anything besides that power. Alright. Can I touch that? Yes! Alright, I'll just sit here and wait. And then we'll get power. Your face is mine! Yeah! Whee! Yes! Alright, let's just run across to the other side and hope for the best. Let's do it. Oh, we've got the life raft things again. Oh, this time it's going to be a little bit hairier. Ooh! Especially with the platforming. That could have gone better. I'm panicking a little bit because I need to time my jumps right. Bollocks. When in doubt, just jump down, try again. Alright, let's go. Alright. Ready. Yep. Ready. Yep. Yep. Yes! I should be safe here. Yes. Right, that's it. This is it. It's all on you, SpongeBob. Jump! Go, Sponge! In your face, I am Captain! You see how I'm playing this a little bit longer, just because this is actually...
this is actually genuinely fun. And it's got some nice difficulty to it as well. Just what I like. Right, can land on there. Right, okay. What's solid and what isn't? Only time will tell. Now the question is, with that conveyor belt... Oh my god. I wasn't looking up here to see where they went. Yeah, well, there you go. Well, oh, there's actually a Krabby Patty up there. That's actually pretty sweet. But anyway, I want to be playing this a little bit longer. I'm going to play all the other mini games and stuff. I'm going to see what else there is to offer here. Because this is actually pretty cool. So let's go out for some final thoughts right about now. And just before we head out for those final thoughts, I just wanted to show this. Yes, that's not rain at the top. That is a... Whenever I seem to jump, or move, or when anything's moving, the graphical glitches seem to get worse. Which leads me to believe that, perhaps my batteries are low? I've not got any other batteries on hand to test this out, but it's possible that my unit is faulty. So don't let the visual problems affect your thoughts on the actual device.
Alright, so what are my final thoughts on 2003's SpongeBob SquarePants? Plug and play. It's okay. It's definitely one of their earliest ones, though. It's not one of their newer ones. It's missing all the background music, which is really telling. It really is telling. Like, when I first turned it on, I genuinely thought there was audio problems with it for about half an hour. I'm not joking, I was fiddling with it. Genuinely thought there was just something wrong with it. It was just no audio. No, it's just got no music. Which upset me, but... I digress. What are the games like? Are the games good for kids? Yeah, they're pretty darn good. They're great for kids, and they're really entertaining. Bubble Pop is alright. It's just more of a breakout clone, which is, okay. It's got all the power-ups, so you've got all that going for you. So if you're a fan of, like, SpongeBob, you get to play as him for Bubbles, which is pretty darn cool. The Surf Adventure one definitely reminds me of Super Mario Land for Game Boy. Really, really good, really fun, nice and entertaining. I did actually really enjoy that one. It definitely gave me... It just made me want to just boot up my Game Boy and just play that instead. Maybe I still will. Now, Invasion of the Hookers, that one's pretty... it got pretty hard later on in the later levels, but it's a pretty much run-of-the-mill game. That wasn't... There didn't have much meat to that one. It was just, just fire this there, fire this there. Meh. Patrick and the Maze, my god. That I still don't know what the heck I'm doing in that game. Man, I played that a whole bunch and I still was like, maybe I should have read it more, I don't know. But still, there was actually a lot to it. It seems they put most of the development time in that Maze game, I will be honest. There's a lot of good stuff there. So it looks like this should have been just called Patrick and the Maze and four other games. But no, gotta get that SpongeBob SquarePants likeness in. It was pretty darn fun. It was alright. It was entertaining. Super Chum Bucket, now that one... I don't know whether the batteries were dying. After I finished recording all of that, and the part where it literally looked really terrible, I went back and played the other games and they were completely fine. So I don't know. It might just be my unit. This is very old. When you think about it, it's 15 years old. It's older than most kids. See what I said there? Dumb. But still, it could be just the age of it. Maybe it's just not designed right. I don't know. So I couldn't tell you because I don't have a second unit to test it out with, and I won't be getting one either. But this is pretty darn fun. I definitely do recommend it. If you can find it on the cheap and your kids absolutely love SpongeBob SquarePants, this is a no-brainer. This is a no-brainer to give them a nice little fun plug and play and a nice little thing to put on the shelf as well to show their love for SpongeBob. Either way, it's a win-win, nice display piece, and pretty much good to go. Now, one thing I didn't do in the intro was I actually didn't show the unit itself, did I? No, so here it is. On the front, you've got your reset button, to go back to the main menu. You've got your on-off switch, which shows a red LED when powered on. And it's just plain all in the back. It takes four AA batteries on the back of it, which is pretty darn cool. And, of course, the little joystick on the front. So fun. As for the button, It's not a clicky one. It sounds like it might be a clicky one, but it's not a clicky one. But it's a nice responsive button. You can tell when you're pressing it. It definitely feels like there's a spring in there, of all things. It even sounds like there might be one in there. I don't know, I might crack this open and have a look. But yeah, pretty darn cool. I do like it, and I do recommend it. So if you can get it on the cheap, definitely go pick it up. Anyway, guys, I'll see you guys next time. Take care, survivors. And what did you think of it? And also, what plug-and-play review should I do next? I don't know.